Hey everyone, welcome back to Gaming News by Gamofeen. My name is Manas, with me is Sushir.
Hello.
And we are here to talk about the biggest gaming news from this week. So Sushir, hit me with it.
let's take it away. In the first news that we have of this week, Sony is winding down development of PlayStation Japan. And for us Sony fanboys, that hits us hard. This developer, which has been like an auxiliary support studio for games like Bloodborne, Demon's Souls, and even original games like Gravity Rush, Last Guardian, Knack, Locoroco, Parapon, the list goes on. The majority of the devs have been let go. Only the localization, the business teams have been left. The Astrobot developer, a Sobi team, has also been left. They will continue and concentrate on their IP. PlayStation headquarters now wants more games with international appeal rather than appealing to a small niche audience in Japan. All parts of PlayStation Japan Studios assets have been now shifted to the global brand. What do you think about that, Manas?
It's very sad, man. Like, Japan Studio has been known for such amazing games. Especially, I think, stuff like Last Guardian, Shadow of the Colossus also, they have their hands on it, right? Shadow of the Colossus.
I suppose so, yeah.
You know, like, it's such powerful games and all of that developer kind of having to back up. It's weird. Even with Sony keh raha hai, shifting focus from Japan to like games with global appeal. Games like Last Guardian, I don't think that was... I don't see what about it appeals only to gamers in Japan. Like, globally, I feel it has the same appeal to as many people as it ever would have. And it's good value to have games like those. Maybe Sony thinks differently. It's a bummer though. Yeah.
Definitely. And one of the other reasons might also be rising costs in Japan. Development costs must be, higher than American cities. So yeah. I suppose that's one way for Sony to go for it. In the next bit of news that we have, which is another, it's one of those fights that don't stop. We have the sinking city. You know that Cthulhu game, H.P. Lovecraft, all kinds of tentacles.
The detective kind of game, right?
The detective and all kinds of tentacles everywhere. That fight between the publisher Nacon and the developer Frogwares just doesn't seem to stop. Frogwares had previously accused publisher that they had pirated a version of the game, made changes and listed it for sale on Steam. Back in late February, they had hacked and removed splash screens, removed the name of Frogware. Frogware blames directly Neopika Belgian dev team, the game, the developers behind hunting simulator games who were a part of Nacon, behind for this. The legal battle in the French courts are still going on. It's over contract breaches, missed payments, intellectual property ownership. And now you can add piracy and theft to it. Sinking City was first removed from all platforms on August 25 last year following these legal disputes. What do you think about that, Manus?
I didn't know ki this was going on with Sinking City. Like, or maybe I heard about it, but I forgot all about it. But I remember ki the game is actually not bad. It's not a great game, but it's... In terms of being a detective game, it's actually pretty good. Like, it's more of a detective game than even Batman at times.
Definitely, the game is quite decent.
Yeah, and I'm surprised that this is happening, and I'm surprised that it's gotten to like this point where developer or publisher ke beech mein itna difference ho gaya ki the publisher is now like downloading a torrented copy or something of the game and then making changes to it and then putting it on Steam, and then developer keh raha hai na ki don't get that version, it has bugs and all, it's not the latest
Absolutely,
version.
Yes.
And of course, they also don't want a pirated version being sold. What's the reason for like, for the last bit of action, like, what's the reason ki the publisher Nacon went and pirated the stuff? Like,
so the publisher Nacon says, according to the contract, they can do this. They have a copy of the game and they made changes to that. But Frogware says that they don't have a legit copy of the game. And you can see that because it's not the deluxe version. There is no added DLC into the version of the game that was up on Steam. The biggest update is that Steam has finally removed the game from the storefront after DMCA takedowns by Frogwares. So now the game is again not available.
Damn, dude. ठीक है, well people can't play it, I guess, for as long as this lawsuit goes on. But मौका मिले तो, well maybe it's time for people to actually pirate and check it out if they haven't already.
So from problems in the Steam storefront, let's move on to the other one. Epic has acquired the Tonic Games Group. Tonic Games Group, who you ask, they're the parent company to the Mediatonic devs of the highly successful Fall Guys. This has been done for an undisclosed amount. In 2019, they had acquired Psyonix devs Rocket League. Epic CEO Tim Sweeney said in a statement, "It's no secret that Epic is invested in building the metaverse, and Tonic Games shares this goal. As Epic works to build this virtual future, we need great creative talent who knows how to build powerful games, content, and experiences." What about that, Manas?
Yeah, that's ये तो मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है, kind of saw it coming. Like Epic showing an interest in Fall Guys while developers, because they also showed interest in Rocket League developers, and that was like the last one of these more not like an Among Us wala success, like an out of nowhere, but Rocket League feels more like ki है ना Rocket League type का success. It just feels different, like good tight gameplay, a fresh new innovative idea being brought out and being brought out well, है ना, like it feels right. And मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है Fall Guys 2 might just be an Epic store exclusive, which I guess it's pretty much a given. अब तो developer ही खरीद लिया. Good for these guys too, Mediatonic. I am assuming कि they'll now have big budgets and bigger ambitions for their next game.
Absolutely, because they sold 7 million copies on Steam. The interesting part over here is that Epic has said that the game is not going free to play when it's making the jump to the Epic Store. We still don't know whether the game will be not available on Steam anymore, just like what happened with Rocket League. Another interesting thing is that the Fall Guys game has been developed on the rival engine Unity, and that is like so different from what Epic usually does. What about that?
I don't know what really to make of that, but I'm assuming ki let this one be, unless ki Epic puts out money ki na chalo yaar tum engine hi change karo apne game ka while it's already out and about. I don't know if they'll make them do that, but definitely Fall Guys 2 is being made on the Unreal Engine 2. On Unreal Engine.
So while you shower out your V-Bucks over there on Epic, let's move on to the other bigwig, Nintendo. So Nintendo Switch, they plan to unveil a new model. What would it be? Nintendo Switch Pro? According to Bloomberg, no else. Bigger Samsung 7-inch OLED with 720p resolution with a thinner bezel. Support for 4K when docked. This OLED will consume less battery, higher contrast, have a faster response time compared to the current 6.2-inch LCD. Samsung is supposed to start mass production as early as June with 1 million unit target per month. The Nintendo president had said in February that they had no plans to announce a new Switch anytime soon. Manas, are you going to change your Switch now that
already I don't use my Nintendo Switch as much. It's a pretty expensive device with pretty expensive exclusive titles on it. So I don't, but I think having a new Switch out in like a year or so does make sense. Kafi time ho gaya for the Switch, and the Switch already wasn't like too powerful, so it'll make sense ki to support maybe games like the next Zelda, which is again like will be an open world game, very systems driven, so it makes sense. I think it should be called the Switch U though, just to go with Nintendo tradition.
So, as since the console is in its fifth year, and definitely then the next generation consoles by Sony and Microsoft are making their mark, we do hope that Nintendo finally plans to bring out this newer Switch, and keeping our fingers crossed for them releasing this in India.
Same official release with official support, and regional pricing will be a dream that Nintendo will never make happen.
About things that don't keep happening, what has happened? GTA Online, and it's not in the news for the right reasons. A GTA Online modder known as Tost has reduced the GTA Online loading times from over 6 minutes to 1 minute 50 seconds. how was this magic done? What do you think, Manas?
I don't even play GTA that regularly these days. Shit, dude, like this might actually get me to play some more GTA. Uske online waiting times and all, waiting times, so look, they come later, but the load times are damn long, dude. Like every time you load up that game, it just takes forever, especially if you're on a console, fir to keep waiting even longer. So a modder being able to do it, and I also heard that he said it's like a one-day job for any Rockstar ke kisi bhi developers. And I wonder how they missed this, or does this? I just can't imagine. Like, if he had said that okay, he reduced the loading time in the single player only, then I understand. Okay, okay, maybe even that would have sucked for Rockstar, but he did it in online, like where you actually connect and jo bhi wo hona hai wo bhi the connection with the Rockstar servers, if all of that, with all of that under like a minute 50 seconds, under 2 minutes, that's pretty awesome.
Definitely, because this Key Knights group found out that the loading time, a part of the loading time, was causing a lot of CPU usage with no disk or network usage, and the net shop catalog seemed to be the culprit. It was it was parsing close to 10 megabytes worth of, you know, JSON files with 63,000 entries. And that might not seem that much, 10 megabytes, but when you multiply that up and exponential growth, that does seem to have an effect. So the main problem seems to be a hash array problem. It's a single thread CPU bottleneck. This came from 2013 by US publisher Take-Two. Definitely needs a revamp. Do you think Rockstar is going to do that for only next gen?
I mean, if it's already possible on current PCs, if the guy did it, it would be great if Rockstar could figure out a way to do it for both the PS4, Xbox One, PC obviously, and of course whenever they have the next gen versions of GTA 5 ready for the new consoles. Man, I really hope they can bring down the loading times even further.
So the time that you remain hopeful and you remove the shark card, you know, from your wallet, we have other news. Cold Iron Studios, they are developing this game called Aliens Fireteam. This new three-player co-op, third-person PvE survival shooter. Oh my God, that's a mouthful. It's going to be out. 40 development team, hard at work. It is set 23 years after the original Alien trilogy. Now, as a Colonial Marine, you are supposed to investigate a mysterious distress signal from a colony yet again. There are going to be 4 different campaigns, 3 levels each, 5 character classes, own abilities, RPG progression systems, 30 guns, 80 weapon attachments, 20 different enemy types. That's a lot of numbers being thrown away. Yeah. New challenge card system which will act as mutators and change the way you play the mission. You can go down on an alien planet, fight xenomorphs this summer 2021. Manas, what are your hopes for this?
When I first heard about it, I was like, why this? Why not like another sequel or something in the vein of Alien Isolation? But I saw the gameplay, and to be honest, Fireteam seems like another word for Colonial Marines. So, but the gameplay does look actually pretty good. Jo maine dekha, I would love to play at least a round of that. And if that is fun, I would like to play more. This looks fun. Wo alien wala, the setting is just so good. That sci-fi setting. And I think they recreated it well enough. I don't know Alien Isolation jitna achha hoga ki nahi. But it does look good. The gameplay that I saw looks good. The shooting, the weapons, I don't know how much variety, how varied it'll actually feel when you're playing. I saw some weapons and all in the gameplay. They did stand out. I'm not sure if they'll stand out enough when it comes to there being 30 weapons. Like, that's a lot. The 20 enemy types. I also saw a few enemy types in that gameplay demo, which was around half an hour long. So, usme there were enemy types, but it's like it's an alien with acid dripping. Like, usse visibly drip ho raha hai. But I thought the aliens were always supposed to be dripping acid if you shoot them. So just to thoda odd lag raha tha ki they're forcing variety instead of there being actual real variety. But hey, I'm still hopeful, because if the game turns out to be good, a good three-player game, almost hold wala wo scene hai. And I one thing that I heard was कि द वर्ल्ड वॉर जी कम्युनिटी द पीपल हु प्ले वर्ल्ड वॉर जी दे आर टेकिंग टू दिस गेम क्वाइट पॉजिटिवली सो आई एम हैप्पी टू हियर कि लाइक द रिसेप्शन इज गुड स्पेशली पीपल हु प्ले गेम्स ऑफ दिस काइंड
डेफिनेटली बिकॉज़ यू बेटर बी हैप्पी बिकॉज़ अदरवाइज दे आर गोइंग टू सेंड सम फेस हगर्स योर वे फ्रॉम दैट न्यूज वी आर गोइंग टू EA ओह माय गॉड EA हैज डिलेड NFS दैट माइट बी अ गुड थिंग दे हैव मूव्ड क्राइटेरियन टू सपोर्ट DICE for Battlefield 6. Criterion had previously supported them for Star Wars Battlefront 1 and 2 and also the Firestorm Battle Royale mode for Battlefield 5. The return to the racing series NFS will happen in 2022. So this year's EA's main racing game might be by Codemasters, their recent acquisition. Respawn Entertainment's founder, Vince Zampella, is also helping out in the live service components of Battlefield 6. It seems like a team effort. But Battlefield 6 might have a modern-day setting, over 128 players, fully destructible environments, and probably launch only on next-gen consoles and PC. Manas, what's your take on that?
Man, honestly, I'm excited for the next Battlefield. I really hope it's like a modern setting like Battlefield 3, 4, or even Bad Company. And yeah, yeah, take all the help you can get. Just put out a Battlefield game that I want to play, man. Like, I think Battlefield 5 and Battlefield 1 were good, but not as good as... I did not have as much fun with them as I did during the Battlefield 3 and 4 days. So, yeah, take right. all the help you can get and give us a good Battlefield. Theek hai. If something else gets delayed, yeah, they do have Codemasters in case they want to put out another racing game, even if it's not NFS. So, it's a good thing, I think.
So we are we definitely going to move on from being a Call of Duty fanboy now?
I think originally I was a Battlefield fan, but with 1 and 5, yeah, World War, us time wala shooting is not what I'm looking for. So if they can get me go modern stuff, I'm back all the way in, baby.
With that news, that's all that we have for this week.
That's it for the news. But we do have one game that I did check out this week, one big game, Outriders, the demo. If you want to hear more about it, we have a video up on the site. I'll leave a link in the description below and you can check that out. I think you should. We talk about it for quite a bit. And with that, we are here. We're at the end of the news. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks, Sushir, for collecting all that news, man. That was quite a bit.
My pleasure.
And we'll be back again next week. So you have a good week and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.